Ja, så har startat upp bikeen och har
quizzes till jag har och
till jag har.
Marschen, jag har chai, marschen med kaffe och dash.
Det är då, då var det en sån tid att jag sa att det stod att det var en sån tid att jag sa att det var en sån tid att jag sa att det pushing this word in sincerity and in truth. And shallow, I'm on to the aquat, be the obedient unto the Holy Father, and take the media this word. This here is your brother, Yassad.
Yakal.
From the Trinidad, James, Prophet Radiation Camp. You know, today we bring in unto you another lesson, you know, willing to edify him.
And,
you know, and
yeah, we are going into some things that, you know, things ahead, based on the way the world going and the way the economy crashing and the way everything actually happening before your eyes, because some people not seeing it. Some people who actually have jobs not seeing it, you understand, because they have a portion, but there are a lot of people who not, you know, who not working, a lot of things that not happening for them right now, but.
Well,
yeah, that's
yeah.
Yeah.
So, we will bring out this first piece up here. This is the book of Ecclesiastes. Chapter 12 and verse 3. In the day when the keepers of the house shall tremble, and the strong men shall bow themselves, and the grinders cease because they are few. You know? Yeah.
And Khan and the keepers of the house, let's talk about Esau. You understand? Esau actually, knowing that he time is coming upon him and getting short, the US dollar crashing. Right? So when the US dollar crashing now, and the people seeing all over that the US dollar have no worth. You understand? Esau now, who know the Bible and know certain things going on have come to pass, because he have a short time. So he knowing that the dollar crashing and that he money not worth no money, nothing really. And nobody, everybody want to go into cash. Everybody want to go into their own thing, because US dollar not back with nothing. So when it's the keepers of the house tremble, they are the keepers of the house. Esau, they trembling. They trembling for a lot of things because they know the time short and that the money not saying nothing and country getting ready to war.
Right. You know? And the grinders cease because they are few. And yeah, that grinders going back to, you know, the people them laboring and working, because practically we all just laboring for this so-called white man. You know? They who look at it. They own all of the major companies in the world that actually run and manufacture everything. You know, and it's say because they are few, right? They have meaning few, just as yesterday. You know, I hear so much people talking and saying, hey, a lot of people are losing their job. People not seeing it that, hey, things gonna get tight just now. You know? A person might just be thinking in their head, because right now they eating and drinking, right? Things still nice with them, all is well. But hey, the way how this system is right, your eating and drinking will not soon cease, boy. Look at how much of them losing their jobs. Look at how much of them have so much bills piled up on their head, bills for rent, all of these things. And those that look out of the windows be darkened, and the doors shall be shut in the streets.
Yeah, because you see, now you know a lot of companies closing now. They're laying off a lot of people getting sent home. You understand? A lot of people can't pay the rent, the grinding cease. Work slow down, right? This whole pandemic, slow down work and slow down everything. You're not seeing people eating like they used to eat. Even the higher ups, people who have no hard money, they're not spending wild anymore, they're spending like how, you know, an average person would spend, because they're not having all that money anymore, so they can't make the moves they wanted to make. But there are rich people who I know have 5-6 cars, sell 2 other cars now, they still live in the same rich living that they were living, you understand? But what the scriptures say about us, it say we are rich, but we rich in the world, you understand? We're not rich in this world, because the time's coming ahead. The poor is gonna have a majority of poor people, and they're gonna actually target the rich. You're gonna be a target. You understand? You gotta be as a martyr, you gotta be all 100 free Lord, because the time's coming, not gonna be nice.
Also to add too, we see that hey, this gonna just jot down to the rich and the poor. Right now the middleman, the middleman that actually fighting and struggling with his business right now. he had a one, he had a close down because he watch out even right now. It is a high demand for the US dollar right now. Right now it is what, 8 to 1?
Yeah.
$8 to 1, and a lot of these big businesses that doing imports of goods and foods and so forth, as the video I did, dark days ahead for China and Tobago. You know that showing you, well, hey, right now we're taking US dollars, it is not $30 to do the transportation, the transportation fee to bring in goods and things. So it's actually getting a little bit much tougher to bring in goods. You know, and we know through the spirit and power of Hashem and Hashai, just now all imports and exports gonna cut. All of them gonna cut. A man gonna desire to go into another city and would not be able to. You know, I was reading an article earlier on saying all who looking to leave the Trinidad and Tobago borders, them had a implementation. So they change the process of you just going and buying a ticket to fly out. You had to now sign up and go through a set of procedures just to leave the country. You know, and we know just now that hey, you had a you know, that so-called VAX to leave this country.
You understand? Without getting cured, you can't leave the country, you can't do certain things like you. And you know that, you know, we trying to be more in the world as possible. We trying to be best to actually, you know, get into the knowledge of the world, study it, try to make yourself better and try to teach people. Because if you don't come in this shoot, right, just yesterday or something, I see two new brothers actually taking in the world. You understand? And that bring a joy to my heart because I know now, right, that I'm more soldiers on the team, and the faster the elected awaken, you understand, is the faster the prophecies come down on this place and the Lord come. Because we getting for the power working, you know, so we working every day. Yeah, we getting paid and we have money, and you know, them things is fool your mind, because you fooling your mind to believe right, you have something and whatever. I fed up, to be honest. I don't want to be working and have money and I have something. Yeah, I have something and I can pay my bills and I can eat. But at the end of the day, I don't want to build no skyscraper and no thing on this place. And that ain't my goal. Them things is not what we should be focused on. We should be focusing on KPI single. We should be focusing on the kingdom. Because kingdom is where you're going to actually get real rest. This is not our rest as the scriptures say. You understand? In the kingdom, we will be able to get real rest. In this kingdom here, which is not our kingdom, we are a slave.
Right? It's all vexation and spirit.
Yeah.
You know, and hey, funny to see how wicked this kingdom is. You're going to work so hard, you buy a nice vehicle or something, and hey, somebody come and steal it. But as the scripture say, you know, set your treasure upon heaven where moth and rust don't corrupt and thieves don't steal.
Can't, because the kingdom of heaven, if that can go on, that's why we bold and say get the kingdom of heaven, whether you believe it or not. You should believe it. You understand what the scripture says, speak to them, whether they hear, whether they forbear. Right now, it's not enough time for me to be speaking to any two-thirds nigga. You understand? Because the Lordship, we hear his voice. So when you hear this word and you're one of the elect men, or you're one of the Lord chosen, you go in and hear this and take this word and do as this word says. Immediately you're going to click, and if it's not immediately, as it was with me, it actually took me I don't know how long, about a week or something, or 2 weeks, to really fall into the shit. However, it will happen. The elect will get revealed because we're fishing for the elect.
Welcome to the Lord's scripture. It says, when the sound of the grinding is low, and he shall rise up at the voice of the bird, and all the daughters of music shall be brought low. Yeah, you know, as the grinding low, you know, it reaching down to the nitty gritty. You know, right now things actually looking poor for this country, but it's still at a slow progressive state with, you know, a little income coming in.
Can, but it's like, yeah, but it's only gonna get worse.
Yeah.
So what do you think? The thing is right now for brother, do get accustomed to this living. Do get accustomed feeling good and feeling like you have money. Because you are accustomed, you had to imagine men breaking your house and just you just giving them up everything. You had to You gotta get accustomed to thinking like that. Get accustomed to thinking, well, all this I have going and go soon. You don't have no gas, so if I have a car, I can't even drive that. You gotta get these thoughts in your mind because you prepare in your mind and yourself for anything that you have. You come by these scriptures, with these scriptures, see. The rich, you have a shy, that's paraphrasing, you have a shy brace, the rich man, right? A rich young man, and you tell him certain things you have to do, and the young man tell him. Yeah, but before he said that, right, the young man tell him, I was doing all these things for my youth. He said, all right, since you're doing all these things, now go and sell everything you have. And the young man couldn't do it. So what the scripture lead to? Right, the scripture lead to see how much them that are rich would make it into the kingdom of heaven.
I would say, it's
easier for a camel to walk through the eye of a needle than for a rich man to make it.
Yeah,
because
when you live in that lifestyle of being up there, you know, a lot of people have so much of pride in them that them can't bring down themselves low. Them wasn't created with humility in them.
Yeah, but thing is, remember that piece of quick look here, talk about that, right?
Yeah.
This book of Ecclesiasticus in the Apocrypha, and I'll start from chapter 1, and I'll start from verse 27. It says, for the fear of the Lord is wisdom and instruction, and faith and meekness are his delight. Right? So let's expound on this a little bit first. It says, for the fear of the Lord, having fear in your heart, shall you do anything that he commands you to do, and not going astray from the commandment, because you're having fear, which is real respect. You understand? For the Lord, real respect is doing the commandments and actually fear anything he could do to you. You understand? Right? It says, it's wisdom and instruction. So when you get wisdom, now you get instruction, right? And when you get instruction is alright, here what to do. This is what you have to do here now. When somebody come into your house, what are you going to do? What the scripture say? The scripture say, agree with your adversary quickly. So when you agree with your enemy quickly, you give them what they want quickly. No small talk. You understand? If so come for you, agree with your adversary quickly before they blow off your head. You understand? We know some of us, we head going to get blow off. But first, the scripture is wisdom and instruction. So we know we had to take wisdom and instruction, right? Secondly, now I would say, and faith, which is you having faith, which is the faith is the measure, faith is the thing unseen. You having faith, you never see the Lord yet. You never see. You just keep in your mind faith that he's going to deliver me out of this situation. And you having no money, and you going through the hard times, and you ain't having nothing, you just having faith, which is you actually believing in it without seeing it happening as yet. Because the Lord never gave you a preview of what going to happen. You understand? The only preview you have is in the scriptures. This is the preview here. So this is where your faith lies, right? Secondly, thirdly now, let's say, and meekness, which is you being humble in all these things, you being poor, all these things, humble, you're not wilding out and going and run with some jakes to go and thief, or you're not going to bug out on the way and eat and you're crying, I don't want nothing to eat. And all these things, you ain't bugging out on these things, right? And it's his delight, right? That could be your delight once you have all these things and all this here. 28 is the, right? Ecclesiastes 1 and 28, it says, distrust not the fear of the Lord when thou art poor, right? That goes back to Job. That's why the scripture Job was, that's why Job's whole life story was the Lord take everything from him. He had nothing, you understand? He was going through all his stress, this, that, but he never distrust the fear of the Lord. He always keep in mind, Yahweh Hashem, Yahweh Shai, so the Lord deliver him afterwards. You understand? Even his wife wanted him to forget the Lord. But Job was a man of the Lord. You understand? Right? It says, distrust not the fear of the Lord when thou art poor, and come not unto him with a double heart, which is your mind. Your heart will represent your mind. Do come unto the Lord with a double mind. You fear him or you don't want to fear him. You want to be in the world or you're in the truth. If you work so, you can't be lukewarm. You had to be one, you can't be 1 foot in, 1 foot out. You had to be both foot in. You understand? You had to be 100 trust. You understand? Verse 29, it says, be not a hypocrite in the sight of men, and take good heed what thou speakest, because we know that, alright, a lot of brothers talking good talk with all the time thing, but the hard times coming ahead, right? You who wanted to focus on your business instead of the word of the Lord, you who wanted to make money, you who wanted to do all these things, you have a judgment because you take your hand from his plow, right? You take your hand from the plow and you leave brothers to battle by themselves. You don't remove your candlesticks, what we know now. Somebody had to fill your position. You understand? Which is the real elect. Because you was not part of the elect if you leave. You just make brothers work. And we not to say we work wasn't vain, because the Lord says speak to them, whether they hear, whether they forbear. So we work, try to build you up, right? And then you just fall by the wayside because you wasn't part of the elect. Right? That's how we do. So we more work had to go, you know, we are new brothers. We had to put in work with them new brothers. Because time's coming hard, the economy gonna crash, money gonna be a waste of time, we had to put trust in you, and these brothers new. So we had to boost them up. You understand? That's what I'm doing.
They always go out the rubber sounds. Yeah, the same book up. Yeah, the same book of Proverbs chapter 18 and verse 10. It says the name of the Lord Yahweh is a strong tower. The righteous runneth into it and is safe. You know? Yeah, because just as strong all these hard times that are approaching, you know, and tremendous times, what we gonna do? We're gonna boast about Yahweh all day long, you know. Yeah, we gonna always be giving praises and glory to Yahweh Shem Yashai. And he gonna direct us and guide us through all of this. You know, that's why it's the name of the Lord is a strong tower, you know, that is protection. The righteous runneth into it and is safe. You know, and who is that righteous? That righteous man is the same man who eating this book and keeping the laws, such and commandments, you know, and going out there and preaching this word and this downfall of this kingdom, that the righteous man. That is speaking of here.
Yeah, but they had in Matthew 6 and 19. In Matthew 6 and 19 one time, but the script, the spirit that lead them, we should talk about all these things now, right?
And you know, this is the book of Matthew chapter 6 and
19.
Verse 19. It says, lay not up yourselves treasures upon earth, where moth and rust doth corrupt. You know, yeah, so it's saying, don't set your eyes upon treasures and have things in this kingdom. You know, because hey, we know this place is soon about to be destroyed. You know, and you, hey, I know some brothers, yes, you know, is that the Lord has blessed some of us. We also, everybody had a portion from the Lord, you know, but you going out there and thinking just upon vanity, I'd gain this and I'd gain that, you know. It say, lay not up yourselves treasures upon the earth, where moth and rust doth corrupt, and where thieves break through and steal, you know, because sometimes, hey, it has so much of them wicked jakes and so forth, hey, they might see you progressing somehow. And because they, within their mind, they don't have, you know, they're gonna, because they just doing wickedly, they're gonna come to steal your stuff. Just as in the great time of Jacob's trouble, you're gonna have a lot of looting, you know. Neighbor fighting against neighbor, brother fighting against brother, because, hey, things just, all hell just break loose.
And next thing too, right, just to add on what your brother say, right, you people can watch me and say we're no men of the Lord, right? Because the thing is, we want this kingdom to crash. You understand? We want all these things to stop. Because it's like Yahushai. Let's use Yahushai for example. When they came for him, right? What take place, right? And Peter drew, he saw them cut off one of the men them ears. But what Yahushai say unto Peter? He tell him, don't think because that time ain't come as yet. He said because the scripture had to be fulfilled. So if the scripture had to be fulfilled, right? If the scripture had to be fulfilled, that's what we had to pray for. We had to pray for a few days. And the scripture says we had to pray for a few days and pray that this kingdom crash. Because they go, we want the economy to crash. We want to come out of this mindset. We want to come out of this, but we can't, you know. So we can't, we mindset, we slight, we can't, you know. You understand? Because when you get money, you will feel a little comfortable, whatever, but there is some spiritual doing nothing. Thinking like that, you will always shake it off. But we miss flesh. But we will still shake it off because we know that, all right, we have our Savior and the Savior are coming for us. And we going into the scripture is the only thing that is actually boosts with faith and confidence when the Lord comes. When I come together, no brothers and not too, but...
Yeah, we will continue. It says, but lay up yourself treasures in heaven where neither moth nor rust doth corrupt and where thieves do not break through and steal, you know, and hey, by you laying up your treasures in heaven is you studying and eating this book, you know, you staying within prophecies and being a watchman, you know. And hey, you waking up your brothers and sisters, you keeping those second commandments. You know, all I just say is you laying up your treasures in heaven. Because hey, this work here is a highly rewarded work. Huh. You know? Hey, we mightn't get the payment now. But hey, as it said, this truth here had patience going into a long suffering.
Yeah.
You know, so yeah, this here it is actually a journey. But through your faith. And you know, you strive within this truth, you're gonna make it.
Yeah, because how a man gonna inherit a kingdom without going through the dangers? You gotta go through the dangers, you gotta go through everything being tested. You understand? Let me try and I feel.
And this year is the Lord putting me through this as a test to strengthen me. You know, just as the brother said, how shall a man inherit a kingdom without going through the dangers set before it? So hey, we feel that make the most high of Hashem Yerushai, you know, the Heavenly Father, so almighty and powerful is because hey, he had a balance. He had a balance of knowing good and knowing evil. And that is the thing, hey, true judgment, righteous judgment, that is just the things that the most high showing me within this life and hey, showing me to walk the righteous path. You know, it's enter here at the straight gate. You are anything to go
already? Yeah, I'll just bring up James 1 and I'll start from 2. It says, my brethren, count it all joy when you fall into diverse temptations. It says, knowing this, that the trying of your faith will get patient, as the brother was just saying. We no longer the kingdom now, and we have to have patience. And the trying of our faith will make us get more patience. You understand? Because the Lord is going to be trying us continually. But Jacob's trouble is the trying of our faith. And the reason why it's Jacob's trouble is because Jacob went and feel it the most. Right? When he's Elamites up in the big mansion with a big house, they had a safe house. These Elamites come together and put up all the money and they end up making a safe house with it heavily guarded. Once they could feed the RFID, so they could feed the they could feed this the family, right? Because the thing they had them doing whatever. All these wicked Elamites and all these wicked Jakes who say they're not going to take it, they're going to take it. As my elder brother say, you will take the RFID. You just say you're not going to take it, but you will take it. Because when you see them, your child hungry and you see that, you know, you're going to take it because you're going to want to live better in this life. You're unconditional to take the get accustomed to these things, you know, the mass, but with you gain, they're checking your radiation every time you go somewhere. There's a condition and state. Because remember, when you RFID is radiation. So when you had a radiation in your body, your hand on your forehead, as the scripture says, you're going to have to put your head or your hand towards that radiation.
Mm.
And then you're going to check it to make sure you have your RFID. It's not like you're checking it to thing, you understand?
And just as we all been, you know, programmed and within this, the steps are bringing forth this mark of the beast. When you go into the grocery, what you have to do, you see this big electronic device, so you have to put your hand to check your temperature or your forehead, you know, so hey, you actually seeing that you living in these times, you actually seeing you, hey, just as just say, you know, that he prayed that the most I remember him in these times here that we never know. He prayed that he is to be in this time because hey, Israel was going through so much havoc, and bondage at that time. You know, yes, we right now, we actually in one of the worst captivity right now, because hey, a lot of people don't know the Yahweh about Shem and Shem. You know, so that is why we out here now bringing back onto this gospel of hope onto you all. So hey,
because a lot of people don't even know that the Israelites to begin with. Back in the days, that's why the scripture say we wax worse than our fathers. Because back in the days, they actually know there was Israelites, they know there was Jews, but they didn't. They still went away and they did wrong before the Lord. But yeah, Ecclesiastes 12 and 1
week. Yeah, right? It's very interesting.
But if you don't get to know the gospel one time right now, in that time, then you wouldn't be able to know it. And that is going back to the Matthew 25, right? Where the five wise and the five wise virgins and the five foolish virgins.
Right, yeah, let's see. This book is Ecclesiastes chapter 12, verse 1. Remember now thy creator in the days of thy youth.
Huh. And yeah. What answer up here? What is the days of your youth? The days of your youth is now. Why they young in the truth? Young in the truth, because I can't tell how wicked Jacob remember the creator in your youth. I can tell them, get to know the Lord now. That's what I can tell them, get them my advice. Any person that like watching this video and in the world, which you mean in the world, if you're not doing no video, you're not preaching, you're not doing any other commandments, you're not praying to Yahweh Hashem Yahusha, you're still calling on Jesus in Islam and all kind of different things. You understand? Repent and tell the Lord now. Which is the same, remember the Lord died. Read me?
Yeah, remember now thy creator in the days of thy youth.
Your youth. You understand?
While the evil days come not, and actually we see the evil days approaching. We actually see lot of the state of economy. You know what? Hey, look at even what's going on in New York, in the whole land of America, in Babylon the Great.
Look what's going on all over the world.
Yeah,
the uproars. Every country having uproars. Russia having a big uproar because they don't like what's going on across. There are problems with the government. In China, it's a big thing. In Asia, in France, in America, with the White House, the White House or the Capitol,
yeah.
Right? Everywhere uproars. In Trinidad, a few months back, had uproars same way.
Yeah.
Right? And we know all like the how about Shem Yahusha. He's showing them what's going to take place even more. Right?
Yeah.
A lot of evil days when I'm coming.
Know the years draw nigh when thou shalt say I have no pleasure in them.
Can, because you know I have pleasure in them days. Right now you could still, you understand? They just show you how this place crashing and people don't know. The evil times that have come, they already. This place crashing and you don't even know. You could have gone freely when I say went to a party. You understand? When I say went to a party and spend one night out and then come back. And you can just wind up on somebody just so, and you can just meet somebody new, and you know, socialize. You can't really know social distance. You gotta wear a mask anyway, you can't even meet all people.
Well, I have a scripture here to bring out. This is the book of Matthew, chapter 24. I will start at verse 37. But as the days of Noah were, so shall also the coming of the Son of Man be. And hey, we see what? You even seen it all going on in the made up cartoon they try to imitate as what went on in the days of Noah. What went on? Noah was going out just as us and preaching, hey, this place gonna have a yeah, just as Noah, he was being out there and preaching this.
What's the word that you're reading, Baba Kusha?
Matthew chapter 24, verse 37.
Alright, yeah, you're planning on it?
Nah, okay. Yeah.
Let's go back up to verse 7.
It says, for as in the days that were before the flood, they were eating and drinking, marrying and giving in marriage, until the day that Noah entered into the ark. Yeah, so it actually spiritual, and it is gonna happen again. This year is just a repeat, because what? It said this earth reserved unto a fire. It wouldn't be destroyed by water. Even the rainbow, there's a covenant showing that, hey,
this destroyed, yeah, with water, you understand?
Can, and hey, we've seen it now, everybody eating and drinking, who passing and scoffing at us on the areas and byways, who thinking, well, hey, they are the truth, and so forth. But hey, it's hey, this gospel, it is hidden unto those that are lost already, boy, lost in this world and lost in all the philosophy and things. It say, and knew not until the flood came and took all them all away, so shall also the coming of the Son of Man be. So just as back in the days of Noah, so it will be now. But hey, just a larger population of people gonna die. By thermal nuclear fire.
Yeah, well, we could jump to the 7, and that's him.
24:7. Yeah. The book of Matthew chapter 24:7. This will be the last precept here. You know, for nation shall rise against nation, and kingdoms against kingdom, and there shall be famines and pestilences, earthquakes in diverse places.
And so when you see scripture say nation shall rise up against nation, you already see it. Iran ready to war. Right? If you look at the article, Iran ready to war right now as we speak. Nation wanna war, America wanna war. Think every nation wanna get back at America right now because they are the bullies. Right? Nation shall rise up against nation, famines, pestilence. You understand? People gonna be food short. Food shortages done going on already. Wake up, see that food shortages done happening already. Pestilence. The pestilence not taking place here. You understand what is happening in places that it will soon gonna be everywhere.
Hey, and also you could actually see this so-called pandemic actually is a pestilence. And earthquakes in diverse places, all these are the beginning of sorrows.
You understand? That's the beginning of sorrows. That's only the beginning. There are plenty things to happen, and that's just the beginning. You understand? Hope this video was edifying to the sheep, right? Again, want to say, Kalhalayam, La Alahayanawa, Yahawa, Bashim, Yahwashai, Bashim, Rakakodash.
Double honors unto the elders at Gate Millstone, you know, and shalom.
Shalom.